Good morning, everybody. Welcome in our webinar. Warm welcome. I see a lot of familiar names in the call. Unfortunately, not the faces. Today, we will talk about our IoT Digital Twin Accelerator Pack, which can help you to connect, to make your hardware smart and to connect it to your business processes, like service management, like invoicing, like replenishment, and connect it also, of course, therefore, to your ERP system, such as SAP, but not limited to SAP. So that's the topic for today. I'm David Pierre. I'm a competence lead at Flexo Digital. And today I'm presenting together with Nicolas Goris, and Nicolas will present himself.
Hi, I'm Nicolas. I'm a digital tech expert at Flexo, and I'll do the technical parts of the solution.
Thanks. Some housekeeping rules for the session. Everybody's muted. However, you can communicate with us via the chat. You can ask us all the questions you want as of now, and we will collect the questions and discuss them at the end of the session in the Q&A. The session is also recorded, and we will share the recording with you after the session. This webinar is part of a webinar series, the Flexo Extension series. That's a series of webinars that we conducted during the summer. Today, we are the 3rd of September. We are talking about the IoT Digital Twin, but we have discussed a lot of extensions, SAP extensions that we have built for multiple customers. And that might also be relevant for you. So don't hesitate to go to our website and you will find all the recordings of all the other webinars as well. Next week is the last webinar of the series, and then we will discuss how you can create an extension. So, for example, suppose that you would like to create an extension such as the that we are discussing today, an IoT Digital Twin Accelerator. How can you do that using SAP Cloud Platform? That is a topic for next week. What is the agenda for today? First of all, we will discuss the business value of IoT. Everything starts in the business needs. So that's the first thing. Why do you need IoT and why do you need this solution? Then we will look at what is on the table. What do we actually offer and what can you do with it? What are the features and functionalities? Of course, including a demo, and also we will open the hood to see what is how it works. Not too much detail because we are limited in time. We only have about 30 minutes, but you will get a feeling how the engine of the solution works. We will also explain how we implement a solution. Typically, IoT projects are not simple projects because you have hardware, you have software, you have a lot of data that you collect. There is an ERP system that you have to integrate. So a good project approach is important. We will also demonstrate that with a customer case, Miko Coffee Services, that is now providing to its customers coffee as a service based on an IoT setup, already live in production for 30 customers. We will discuss that. And finally, we will send you back in your code or back in the office with some key takeaways and also the Q&A. So first of all, why would you invest in IoT? First point is that we are already living in a Netflix or a service, digital service economy. That is already the reality. So we don't buy videos anymore. We watch streaming Netflix movies. We don't buy music anymore. We watch or we listen to Spotify. And this will only continue. For example, in the future, we will probably buy less and less cars, but we will subscribe to a car sharing service, which is also digital, which has an app, which has a portal where you can see how much you have driven, what the cost is that actually incurred. And this is also interesting for the B2B market. So for example, at our customer Miko, they can sell you a coffee machine, but they can also sell you coffee as a service. And they will just measure the amount of coffee that you use and they will bill you accordingly. So this is a completely digital service-oriented business model that is only possible if you have something like IoT to harvest that data and to know what the customer is doing and how much of your product he's actually consuming, pay per use. Second of all, customer experience is everything today. So, of course, quality of the product itself, the price, efficiency, that's all important. But today here, I think in Europe and in the West, we really make the difference with a fantastic customer experience that really is compelling and that convinces the customer to stay with us. Think about Bol.com, think about Coolblue. These are really brands that have a digital experience and the best customer service there is in the market. And that's how they make the difference. And that is also something that you can achieve via IoT. If you can plug in to what the customer is actually doing, have a very intimate relationship because you are literally connected to your machine, to your factory, to your customer product, then you can really know what the customer is doing. This is also completely transparent, by the way, because you can check that via a customer portal. But since you know what the customer is doing, you can also do smart recommendations. You could say, you have been consuming product ABC, maybe also product XYZ is very important or relevant to you. Would you like to use that? Do product recommendations, upsells, cross-sells, and so on. And finally, not finally, but another big benefit, I think, is proactiveness. If we can really plug into the factory, into machines, PLCs, assets, to know what the status is of those assets, whether they are internal or at the customer, we know what the status is. We know if there is an error, then we can act before the customer or the end user knows there is a problem. Or at least a lot faster than we were used to. We were used to get a phone call, there is a problem, and only then we can start action. But if we can remotely monitor the devices, then we can already take action before the end user actually knows there is a problem. So proactive customer service in a service-based digital business model. That is really what IoT enables. What is really important and what is the basis for all of this is, of course, data. We need to harvest, we need to collect data about what the customer is doing, what the machine is doing, what the factory is doing, what anything is doing, so that we can act upon that. And how do we do that? Simply by connecting hardware. And we can actually connect any piece of hardware that can be a vehicle or a machine or a factory or an air compressor, a coffee machine, electronic tools and devices, medical devices. We can connect any piece of hardware that can send data to us. We provide an endpoint, an API if you want, that can receive the data in a certain digital twin in the cloud. And any device that we can connect to that endpoint, that simple HTTP endpoint in the cloud, can actually be connected and become a smart device. And what can you do with that? If you manage to do that, and of course with our solution we can, what can you do that with that? For example, Philips. We all know that Philips sells light bulbs, LED lighting, also kind of cool lighting. They have a brand, Signify, that sells the lighting for them. But they don't only, as a retailer, you can just tell Philips, provide me with lighting for my shop. And you don't purchase the lighting, you just purchase a service that they will provide a lighting and you are built on the consumption. So a flexible lighting contract for your shop in a B2B environment. Another example is John Deere. John Deere is a global, one of the biggest global manufacturers of tractors and farming materials. And these tractors are smart. So that means they are connected and send data to John Deere. So John Deere captures a lot of data, but not only about the tractor. The tractor is harvesting crops, but it also collects data about the crops. For example, what is the humidity of the field, the acidity, temperature of the field, and this data is also collected, sent to John Deere, and John Deere offers that data to the farmers as an extra service. And so they created a completely new digital business model on top of the manufacturing of tractors. And another example is, for example, Hilti, also very famous brand. Yeah, I think most people have a screwdriver or a drilling machine in the basement of Hilti. But they also deliver in B2B contexts to companies, tools, mechanical tools to construction companies. They are used in big constructions where hundreds and hundreds of tools are in use. And they deliver a smart, the on-track asset management system, which you see on the left, which actually via IoT keeps track of where all the tools are to avoid theft, loss, and any issues that you might have with the tools. So there is a lot of possibilities, so many that it's almost unimaginable. and we are very curious and keen to see if you see opportunities like that in your company. So we have a small poll. And the question is, what kind of opportunities? I discussed different possible opportunities, more related to service model, building a subscription-based service model, more related to customer experience, digital experience, personalization, providing a customer portal to the customer so that he can follow up on the products, that we can offer new products, but also a model more related to asset management and service, follow-up of assets, asset tracking, customer service, predictive maintenance, predictive service, that kind of stuff. So we were very curious to see what you see as potential use cases in your company. So I see already things moving in real time, of course, because this is about real time today. So we see that assets and service management is currently leading the race, I would say. Just shortly behind that, improve customer experience, innovation, transparency, and also changing business models, offering the product as a service. So yeah, I think this is, I think for customer service companies, of course, proactive service and asset management is a very important topic. So thanks for your feedback. That's really interesting. And that brings us actually at the next topic in our webinar, and that is the what. What actually do we offer in our solution? And Nicola will explain you all about it.
Thanks, David. All right, so what do we actually offer? Well, our package contains three key ingredients to make it a big success. On the one hand side, we have the SATAD platform as our foundations. It offers numerous services that support different solutions. In this case, for example, we're going to use services like the IoT service. We're going to run UI5 applications. We are going to create a portal with Fiori Launchpads, making visible the necessary applications for that customer. We're going to integrate it with the ERP, our SAP system, or even other systems. This through the cloud platform integration services. And next to that, we are offering some pre-built Flexo components that we created through experiences at different customers that are enabling us or allowing us to offer a solution based on best practices and even market standards, and this even in a faster way than before. And all of this, we are offering you or delivering you in an integrated end-to-end project approach, where you as a customer don't have to worry about succeeding, and you can focus on creating new business models. Let's dive a little bit further into the offering. On top of or on the bottom, if like you want to see, we are going to create a connection with your IoT. And we will help you in connecting your machines and them to send data to the cloud. This with the digital twin. I'm going to go deeper into the digital twin in a few moments. But let's go further. And then we have our data lakes. Our data is stored in the cloud, our measurements. And this data will be considered by the system itself. Will it be hot data? Will it be the warm data, cold data? It's all managed by the cloud. We don't have to intervene and tell the system which data is which. So pretty cool, no? On top of that data, we're going to create a real-time customer portal where we can see the real-time measurements of our machines. We can see where the machine is located, monitorize which numbers are going up or down, and this in real time. Of course, we're going to take into consideration authorization and security, so you can only see your devices as a customer, and of course, not devices from other customers. And then we can even go further and create a SAC dashboard, a sales insights dashboard, where we can drill down on data and get valuable information about our customer, even further personalize the offering for them. Of course, this complete solution is integrated with our ERP system, and we can even go further and create rule-based integration. So for a given set of rules, we're going to trigger some processes in our ERP system. And of course, this is an integration that we deliver end to end. So maybe it's a little bit abstract, and maybe we can just check out the demo a little bit. So imagine you're a customer in a coffee business, and so coffee beans are your main product. But is it all we can do? No, of course not. We can also offer services on top of that coffee beans and machines. So what if we would make our machines smart and be able to monitor them from a distance? It enables us to create new business models where we can, for example, offer services to automatically replenish the machines even before they go they run out of beans, making sure that our customer has always enough coffee to drink in the morning. Awesome. Let's take a look at the dashboard. Here we see an overview of our machine where we can monitor it from a distance. We get an overview of the machine, like 360 sales overview of our customer, but then in this case for a machine. You can offer this dashboard to your customers, and they will be able to see their consumption of different machines. Of course, again, taking into consideration the necessary authorization. So which data do we see on this view? Well, it's a combination of two parts. We have on the one hand side data coming from our ERP system, master data and process data. And on the other hand, we have usage data, the measurements coming from our digital twin. We can even drill down and, for example, see the different usages from the machine. In this case, every block on the dashboard represents a physical button on the machine that is being pressed. And for this, we can, for example, see now that the strong coffee is being used a lot of times and is very popular. On top of the dashboard or the view of the machine, we can see a combination of different ERP related sources. We have on the one hand side equipment master data, and where we show which equipment is being viewed at this point. We can see contract data of the customer, when does a contract start, when does it end, and things like that. And we add digital twin data. For example, when was the last time that the machine had an error? Is it running smoothly now, yes or no? Now let's take a look at the dashboard. On the left-hand side, we have devices based on authorizations, right, the devices and their locations. When we drill down, we see an overall consumption of the device. Even go deeper, again, the master data that we can see. And then we see the consumption of all the different kind of drinks in this case. We can go further and see the consumption of one drink. And even take another time measurement and see in this time period, how does the drink is being consumed. So that's pretty neat. And it allows us and the customer to follow up on the usage of the machine. On top of that dashboard, we can also offer SAP Analytics Cloud dashboard, where our sales department can drill down on data and get valuable insights on the customer and even offer them more personalized services. For example, when was the espresso being used the most? Is cappuccino quite popular or not? Maybe in the winter, is there being used more hot cocoa or not? That's all questions that we can ask as a sales representative and even answer them thanks to this dashboard. So how does this solution look like a little bit more technical? To start with, I'm going to explain a little bit the digital twin for those who don't know it yet. So we have a physical machine. That physical machine is gathering measurements, how the machine is being used, when something is going wrong, and stuff like that. Most of the times, these measurements are staying on the machine itself. So that's a pity we cannot remotely access this data. So how cool would it be if we create a digital representation of that machine, enabling us to recreate that machine, allowing to put in all the different measurements that can be measured by the machine itself, store it in the cloud, and then really create our digital twin. Connect the machine with that digital twin so the data can be accessed via the cloud. Would be cool, but we can create even a dashboard on top of that, or even other applications where we can remotely monitor that data from the machine. We can even offer that application to our customers so they can monitor it as well. Thanks to the UI5 technology that we use, it can be accessed from any device. So mobile phones, laptops, tablets, everything can access that dashboard. We can not only see data and monitor it, but we can as well make sure that data is going back to our ERP system, for example. So we could create invoices, we could create orders in ERP, we can even update perhaps even customer data. So actually it's the digital twin, the digital twin that is at the core of our solution. It enables us to combine measurement data, master data, location data, customer data, environment data, transactional data, maybe even other sources of data all together and to put it into a dashboard in one view, a 360 view of that machine for our customers. All this is done in a low-code environment, so it's not really programming that we have to do. We really have to configure everything. So no worries there, no hardcore coding needed. The platform itself offers also open APIs, so we can retrieve the data from the cloud and use it in portals, analytic dashboards, etc., or maybe even other applications that you would need. We can add rule-based integration with ERP. So we can, for example, in a given set of rules, let's trigger process is in ERP. And all this is 100% cloud-based and managed by SAP. So we don't have to worry about running the clouds. How would it look like that creating the digital twin in the cloud? Well, yeah, you would really create all the different measurements that are possible on that device. You would create it in the IoT Thing Modeler, and then you're able to use HTTP endpoint, for example, to send data to the cloud and to capture it there. We can connect it with our SAP system through, for example, the XAP Cloud Platform Integration service, and we can trigger data going back to our SAP system or retrieving it from there. As said, we could create rules for certain given scenarios where, for example, your machine is running low on coffee or milk. When it's running low, we can create an order in SAP to make it possible to replenish the machine. But not only this, we can also create notifications in SAP, for example, where let's say a machine is making some weird noises, or the coffee that is being produced is not good, and we can measure it through our IoT solution. And if something is going wrong, we can create a notification in SAP and thus creating the possibility of a service engineer going on site when something is possibly going wrong. How are we able to do this? Well, this is thanks to the SAP Cloud Platform. We were looking at, are we going to do it all by ourselves, or are we going to use SubCloud Platform? And that SubCloud Platform came out as the winning part. And there we're going to use different services, as mentioned before. And we're going to use IoT services and to create a digital twin to capture the data and to store it in the cloud. We're going to use a cloud portal service as well to create a launchpad to offer you and customers UI5 applications, again, based on security and authorization roles. We can, on top of that, create a SAC dashboard, providing you as a company insights in your customer usage, and even go predictive. This can be integrated with your subsystems or even other systems to CPI, through CPI. And we can add even other services like, for example, identity authentication. We can install an IDP and stuff like that. We can create chatbots offering customers conversational experience where they can ask, for example, for how is my machine running? Are there any problems? Stuff like that. We can add machine learning, or we can offer API management where you can even, for example, monetize data going out of your IoT platform. All this we are offering in an accelerated approach. Why? Because it works and it's cool. What would be a typical implementation? Well, we see two things. And we are going to start most of the times with a pilot and create minimal viable products. Start small, and then we're going to make it end-to-end. And so really from we started, of course, your development environment, but we're also going to put it on your productive environment. We start with 1, 2, 3 devices, and we'll see when it works, and we can go further and industrialize it. But we're only going to do it when everything is working end-to-end. In the initialized phase, we're going to transfer our knowledge, share it with you guys, make sure that you understand everything as well as we do, and we can start adding additional features, and of course, adding more devices. So you start with a few devices, and then you can go bigger and bigger and bigger. So now we saw a little bit what we are going to offer you, how we are going to accelerate, and how we are going to support you. Maybe it's time to look at a real-life case. So maybe, David, you can tell us a little bit about it.
Yes. Thank you, Nicola. So I will tell the story of our implementation of exactly this solution at MIKO. MIKO also shared the testimonial, by the way, in a webinar already in June. If you are interested in their testimonial, then we can also always share that recording with you. The story of MIKO is a coffee as a service story. That means that MIKO sells coffee, but they also sell coffee machines. And of course, the coffee is consumed through the machine. So via the machine, we know how much of the product the customer is using. This can be used in sales, in service, and of course, can improve the whole experience of the customer himself. A pay-per-use model, which is really efficient, subscription-based. We connect to the coffee machines. Currently, MIKO has 30 customers live in Belgium, connected, running. Automated invoicing, so the invoice is built, billing is happening directly based on the metering, automated metering on those coffee machines. And they also create automatic PM notifications in SAP ERP, in SAP ECC, if there is an issue. So if there is error statuses on the machine, different parameters, and then automatically PM notifications are created and sent to the service department. They want to roll out a solution from 300 to 400 still this year. They have extra focus on this project because this is digital and online business. And in COVID times, what are we looking for? Digital and online business, of course. So lots of potential and lots of expectations, and also lots of benefits. If you look at the benefits, and this is really numbers that we got from MIKO, based on the first experiences with those 30 customers that are already live. So there is a direct impact on cost efficiency in the customer service department. Why? Because of course now there is remote monitoring of the machines, there is automatic metering and billing. So people, there is no technicians or no Miko employees have to go on site to check how much coffee has been used and to then make a note and put that on the desk of the billing department. This is now fully automated. On the other hand, also in the customer service, there is preventive maintenance. They had to go every 2 weeks, they had to go on site to check on the health of the machine. This is not required anymore. Now they only go when there are issues reported via remote condition monitoring. There is transparency to the customer. The customer gets this real-time IoT, knows what he's consuming, can check out all of his machines, of course, only his or her machines, evidently. And also important efficiency gain, but also better cash flow. And that is also very important because they can always invoice. They always have the billing data. They also always have the correct metering data. In the past, they had often bad data, wrong indexes. No one went to the customer that month because somebody was sick. So they didn't have any data to bill. And now there is always, every 2 weeks, they can send an invoice. So they have a way better cash flow. So a successful project and extra focus with also the COVID crisis. I think that was Miko. That brings us at the key takeaways, a summary. I will try to summarize everything, recap a little bit. First of all, key benefits for the customer, as I said, customer experience and transparency, and that is closely linked. If the customer knows what he's consuming in a pay-per-use model, that brings a lot of comfort to the customer, but also to Miko, because you know that the data is always correct, the invoice is always correct, you can check everything online. That is important. And also the pay-per-use model, we see also, by the way, in the software market, now with the corona crisis, that there is a lot of interest, more interest in cloud software, software as a service, because of a preference for OPEX rather than CAPEX investment, of course. So this is also an interesting commercial model, especially today. Second of all, sales department, as Nicola mentioned, the sales department gets the most intimate relationship that you could have with your product at the customer side, a direct real-time connection. So a new dimension in customer intimacy, I would say, provides so much valuable information to the salespeople, and they can use it to recommend new products, to do upsells and cross-sells of things that they weren't aware about before. Service department will be really happy. They can work more cost efficiently. They have to go less on site. They don't have to do meter readings anymore. They don't have to do all of those preventive anymore. Maybe they still have to do some, but less than before. So they can have a more profitable service model. And they have lower costs, so they will become more profitable. And finally, of course, and most importantly, proactivity. The best customer experience is a proactive customer experience, and that is what you can offer. And then finally, I have seen in the registration list that there is also a lot of IT colleagues, I would say, in the call. And what IT wants to do, and that's also what we try to do, is of course bring innovations based on new technology. But what we try to avoid is to bring too much complexity, because you have to be able to business and reduce risk, and complexity is risk. And with this solution, completely based on cloud platform, this is a platform as a service. So this is completely cloud-based, that we plug into the hardware on one side and on the ERP system on the other side. But everything is prepackaged by Flexo in cloud platform. And so low complexity, low footprint, let's say, little installations, yet a lot of innovation, end-to-end integration via cloud CPI, cloud platform integration, everything connected, and also low code. So rather configuration than programming, because we have already a lot of building blocks pre-packaged for you. So recapping what we actually offer, the digital twin as the heart of the system that plugs into hardware, harvests all the data in the hardware, stores it in a cloud data store, that data in a smart way in this digital twin data model, that we can visualize in a real-time dashboard for employees, for the management, for the customer. If you want, we can also aggregate that in an analytical view for the sales department, service department. We connect to ERP to create service notifications, to automate billing cycles, to go for pay-per-use, and everything is running on SAP Cloud Platform that we pre-configure for you, so you don't have to dive into Cloud Platform and understand the 80-plus services that it contains. That is what we do for you, in fact. The solution is also available in the SAP App Center that you can Google, and then you type IoT or Digital Twin and you find our solution. You also find some example pricings there. There is a movie, extra screenshots, extra information. So I would say check it out. And then finally, I would end keeping John Deere in mind, power to the data. Connect now, harvest to harvest tomorrow. If you collect the data today, then you can harvest insights and new business models, new benefits tomorrow. And that's what we wish you to stop this, to end this webinar, in fact. So that leaves us with questions. And we are very curious, and I'm looking at our colleague, Jeff, to see if there is already questions available. So I'm going from the top, can the solution be integrated with CRM as well? Yes. So in fact, we are very agnostic to what we can integrate. It's a cloud solution, so we can connect to SAP ECC, what we did at Miko, but that's S4HANA is very comparable. That's not a problem, but also CRM, even ServiceNow, Salesforce, that would all be possible because everything is microservice based in the cloud. It's all about APIs today. So yes, that's possible. What needs to be installed in the landscape? So I explained that it is a cloud solution primarily. However, we have to connect to hardware. We have to connect to potentially an on-premise ERP system. So we do need to make a connection somewhere. And the most important component that you need to install is SAP Cloud Connector, which connects SAP Cloud via a reverse proxy, very secure system via SSL and encryption with your on-premise landscape. And via that pipeline, we can connect to any on-premise system, in fact, and also indeed to ECC and other systems. It is all dark here. Next question. How long did it take to get the connection going from the hardware to the backend? As Nicola explained, typically we do first a pilot phase where we try to connect end-to-end the whole chain for one device or customer or machine. That would typically take, I would say, 4 to 8 or 5 to 10 weeks. Depending on the dependencies, it's an integration project. Integration projects are always, there are always dependencies. You need specific people in the organization. That is the key. The dependencies, I would say, is the key driver for the elapsed time of the project. If everything is available, it can be 4 to 5 weeks. We can have a first scenario going if we work efficiently and really dedicate the project with the right people in a Scrum team and few sprints, then we 4 to 5 sprints of a week, then we can get already one scenario running. How simple is it to get started with such a digital twin? As I said, in general, I would say we have to be very honest about it. An IoT project is an integration project. You meet people from the factory or from the hardware specialists. That you need to define how these components will speak to each other. You need to connect to ERP, you have the cloud, you have a lot of data. Analytics is involved, so it can be complex, and that's also why we created this package to accelerate the deployment. And we have already all the components. We do a feedgap to your requirements in a feedgap workshop. We can also do some prototyping if you have specific requirements. So yeah, with our accelerator, it's anyway a lot simpler. And also the experience of doing this a few times for a few customers, of course, that really makes a difference in the approach. Does the platform support predictive analytics? Yes, it does. So what we deliver standard, the standard is that we just create notifications based on a real-time status on the machine. So condition monitoring. That is not yet predictive, but what you can do is put all of the data that we collect, send that to SAP Analytics Cloud, or SAP Analytics Cloud has a standard connector to the solution, and also has a component Smart Predict that connects to the solution, and there you can start playing, find key influencing values, correlations between data, and then do predictions on top of that. Also, the storage is based on HANA, by the way. So the storage of the solution is based on a HANA service in the cloud. So that also has predictive capabilities out of the box that you can consume in SAC. Is it possible to build up internal competences on this, or are we always relying on a SAP partner for future rollouts? Good question. At MIKO, we did the pilot together with MIKO, and we scaled until from 1 to 2, 3 customers. Those customers were live. First, we deployed on a Flexo demo environment, even in production, which I actually cannot say, because actually in production that is not allowed. But it was just for pilot purposes. But we can do a pilot on our system. That is important to remember, I think. And from that point on, we did a knowledge transfer to MIKO, and now the MIKO IT department is completely managing the solution and doing the rollouts. And apart from telephones once in a while and some emails, actually they are completely doing everything themselves now. Is the solution possible for ECC or only S4HANA? Solution supports both, especially plant maintenance for notifications. Hasn't changed much in S4HANA, especially the data model. So that's not a big difference, or no difference at all, actually. What are the lessons learned from this project? I guess then that you mean the MIKO project. So I think one of the key lessons learned also for MIKO, but also for Flexo actually, is that that SAP can sometimes have the perception of being a heavy environment, a heavy system, heavy deployment, a lot of work to implement, and also expensive sometimes in terms of licenses, unfortunately. Sometimes that is also true, but in this case, this is completely the opposite, actually. And I can share, for example, that for €10,000 per year, you can already have, in terms of subscriptions, cloud subscriptions, that you can already have a basic environment live. So a basic environment for example, a limited amount of devices, I think up to 500 devices, which is already something. But it depends on the amount of data that you will store. So it depends on a lot of parameters. But I €10,000 a year for a basic environment, that's not a lot of money, I think. So this is really a cost-effective solution, and it's also easy to implement because it's completely cloud-based. And I think that was an eye-opener, not only for MIKO, but also for us sometimes. And then finally, what are the hardware or technology requirements in your machine to make a connection? How do you connect each button of your coffee machine with your digital twin? Yes, this is also a good question, of course, because this is really machine and hardware specific. So in the case of MIKO, for example, MIKO had in-house engineers, an in-house engineer, that developed a custom module to connect, a custom hardware module to connect to a certain type of machines. They also have other types of machines, and they have to build another hardware connector for those machines to send the data to our solution. This is something in the case of Miko that Miko did themselves, but in other cases, we also have a partner in the Kronos Group, Aptus, which is an IoT engineering specialist. They don't know anything about SAP, but they know everything about hardware and IoT, and they can develop this kind of modules also for you, for us. That's a possibility. Sometimes products are smart out of the box. For example, printers, they already have a lot of intelligence. They have they can send data to a network share where we can pick it up. Medical devices, the same. We have seen medical devices that have they are completely electronically and digitally enabled. So you can just configure them to send data to an FTP server. So it can be very different. Sometimes we have to make it smart with hardware in the case of a coffee machine. And sometimes it's already out of the box and we just have to align with the people and set up the connection somehow with some scripting. Always find a solution. I think quickly the last question. So that's the end of the webinar. I would like to thank you all for joining. I hope to see you next week. Next week it's Nico De Lener. That some people might know that will explain you all about SAP Cloud Platform and how you can create a solution like this. So I would say stay tuned and see you next week at 11.
Yep.
And also Nicola,
big thanks.
See you. Bye-bye.